Hello everyone, my name is Jeff Cooper's Ghost. Today we're going to be examining the difference a red dot sight can make on your pistol shooting. I'll be doing this test with two different handguns, a Glock 19 and a Glock 43. The Glock 19 has a set of Heine straight 8 iron sights on it. We have a replacement slide with a Trigicon RMR. We'll be using a Heine tritium front sight on the Glock 43 and the built-in iron sights on our Hollow Sun 507. I'll be shooting three 5-shot groups at three different distances with each pistol, with each type of sight, and then we'll examine the differences. The ammo I'm going to be using for this test is Defiant's new range training ammo in 115 grain. This is ballistically matched to their TCX Total Copper Expanding Plus P defensive ammunition. Now this test is going to be from the point of view of a shooter with about 15 years of pistol shooting experience, corrective eyeglasses with a prescription, and I also suffer from astigmatism. Now, if you don't know what astigmatism is, imagine a superimposed image over what you're looking at, slightly elevated. So when I see the top of a curved line or a straight line, it almost looks like there's a double image floating right above what I'm looking at. I'm going to set you guys up with a tripod and we're going to do this test. We'll start with the Glock 19 iron sights at three different distances with three 5-shot groups. Here we go.
Okay, I'm gonna go pull targets and swap slides for the red dot sight. Okay, I'm gonna load mags, swap slides, and do the test with the red dot on a Glock 19. Okay, Glock 19, red dot, 5 shots at 3 different distances. Okay, I'm gonna go pull targets and set up for our Glock 43 with iron sights. Okay, here we go with the Glock 43. I'm going to use the rear built-in iron sight. I'm going to let that sight and turn the power all the way down. 5 shots at 3 different distances. Okay, I'm going to pull targets, post the targets for my red dot sight, reload, and shoot the test for a red dot.
Couldn't get it back together here. But I've actually never been trained on something, too. I did all that myself. Well, blocks, I've done the advanced block on like 4 or 5 regular block on which we haven't shoot for a few years. Until I finally decided that, no, I'm not doing this anymore. I can still work on. I haven't since we went to all the slim lines and the small blocks. I haven't haven't been to a Glock ammo school. I'm not going to go. David's got the one that I got. I tried to tell David he's been there. He redid his range safety officer last year. Went to the school down here again. I wanted him to come down and start doing range safety officer stuff. He works days, but he could do the weekends. He'd do 1 weekend a month. I'd much rather use some give a recommendation about somebody I know than just a business card. I've actually had to use Dan Stone, who's not a gunsmith, but he's been doing work on stuff. He did some restoration that I've seen, and if I know he's good, I had him work on a gun for him. I told him what he was doing. I said, I can't figure it out. Here, you work on it. He says, $25, okay. He's worth that to me. He probably fixed it in 10 minutes.
Guys, I'm going to take the Glock 43, red dot sight, 5 shots at 3 different distances. Here we go. Okay, that's our test, you guys. I'm going to pull targets, and then we're going to examine the results.
Okay, let's take a look at the Glock 19. It's 7 yards. We don't see much of a difference. I can get that group a little closer. These are 8.5 by 11 sheets of paper. Let's look at the Glock 19. Iron sights at 15 yards. And here's the red dot at 15 yards. These are staples down here. With our iron sights, it looks like we're pulling to the left. We pulled one round off to the left. With the red dot, I'm able to keep all five on that 8.5 by 11. Let's look at the Glock 19 iron sights at 25 yards. And here's the red dot at 25 yards. So, not too much of a difference. I'm still pulling shots to the left. I was able to keep three on paper, and I pulled most of my shots with the red dot. That's a fucking Glock 43. Fuck, wrong target. Here we go, Glock 19. Red dot, 25 yards, only one hit. Take a look at the Glock 43 with iron sights at 15 yards. We have three hits. No. Let's back up to 7 yards. Here we go. 43, irons, 7 yards. And 43, red dot at 7 yards. Again, similar results to the 19. We're keeping all five on paper in a pretty good size group for 8.5 by 11 sheets of paper. Let's look at the Glock 43 at 15 yards with the irons and the red dot. Now this is where our difference comes in. I'm able to keep all five shots on paper with the red dot. At iron sights with the at 15 yards, I've got three hits on paper. One just clipped the bottom there. At 25 yards, irons, zero hits. With the red dot, two hits. Again, I'm not the best shooter in the world. Never claimed to be. And I have corrective lenses with astigmatism. So you guys can see from those results the effects that a red dot is going to have over irons for what I would call a pretty average pistol shooter. Thanks for watching, guys. Thanks for the subs. Thanks for the likes. Stay tuned. Stick around.